Why Trevor Noah thinks Trump's awful tweets aren't the worst thing in the world. It's United Nations week, which means leaders from around the world have gathered in New York to discuss major global issues, an event Trevor Noah describes as Comic Con for diplomats. It'll be President Donald Trump's first time joining the assembly, so he did what any new world leader joining the conference should do. He went on Twitter and gave nicknames like Rocket Man to North Korea's nuclear weapon-possessing leader, Kim Jong-un. It's great to know that if America is ever in a war of bitchiness, President Trump's got it covered, the Daily Show host said Monday before imitating POTUS giving orders to unlock the SAS codes. I will say this, Noah noted, we know Trump is definitely taking Kim Jong-un seriously now because he's officially given him a nickname. You realize he only does that with all his greatest enemies, low-energy Jeb, little Marco, lying Ted. But Kim Jong-un wasn't Trump's only Twitter victim this weekend. The president also took aim at Hillary Clinton, literally, after retweeting a video that shows him hitting a golf ball, followed by 2011 footage of then-Secretary of State Clinton tripping and falling while boarding a plane. The video was cut to make it look as though Trump hit her with the ball. Although Noah admitted the tweet was in poor taste, but added, maybe it's not the worst thing in the world. Did you notice that Trump sent out these tweets right as he started making deals with the Democrats? Noah said. Protecting dreamers, raising the debt ceiling, postponing the wall. Right now, Trump's base is furious with him, so to make them happy, he throws them a mean gif or two. I feel like this is a trade that I can live with, the comedian quipped. Trump gives his followers offensive tweets, and then he gives the rest of America policies that move the country forward. If it helps, we'll even make the gifs for you, Mr. President. Noah also beamed that the Emmy Awards were so full of black people this year, but he warned of history's tendency to repeat itself. Judging from America's history, we have to be careful for next year, because any time a black person wins something for the first time, the next time around, there's always an overcorrection, Noah said as an image of former President Barack Obama flashed on the screen behind him. So just be ready for 2018 when Steve Bannon wins Best Actor in a Drama.